teachers, I am so honored that you are giving your time to watch this video to enrich the lives of your students. In this video, I hope to give you tips that will save you some time too. Here we go. Bookmarks are a link that you can save on your browser as a quick one-click button to a site. They show up on your bookmarks bar on your computer. The best part is that your bookmarks bar will show on all of your devices you are logged in on by syncing with your Google account. Like any teacher, I have a lot of sites up on my computer, and I don't know about your device, but my school-issued Chromebook cannot function if it has more than 7 sites opened at once. It slows down my computer and makes it near useless. But man, do I have a great solution for this. Bookmarks. Let me show you how to make a bookmark. First, go to a site that you frequently visit. Click on the star icon in the URL box. A new box will appear and it will allow you to choose the name, which you should shorten if needed. And then make sure it says bookmark bar under that and click done. Now click on the 3 dots in the upper right hand corner, hover over bookmark, then click bookmark manager. Here you can rearrange your bookmarks that show up on the bookmark bar. To rename one, highlight the one you want to rename, then click the 3 dots on the right of it, click edit, rename it, then click save. If I can remember what the link is by looking at the icon logo, then I take off the text altogether. Most of the time though, I just rename it to make it shorter so I can fit more site links on my bookmarks bar. Here you can also determine their location by dragging and dropping them in the order you want them to be on the bar. The bookmark that we just made is going to show up at the bottom. So we are going to scroll to the bottom, click on it, and drag it to the top. Then you can decide where you want it to go. And now you should see it on your bookmark bar. Dang, now you have everything at your fingertips. With one click, you are instantly wherever you want to be. Don't worry about the bookmarks that do not show up on the bar, because you can click on the double arrows on the right side of the bar and scroll to find the one that you want. Pretty cool, huh? But wait, one thing that kind of bothers me is Google Classroom. I mean, I love it, but if I want to find a specific class, I need to first go to Google Classroom, wait for it to load, then scroll down, find a class, and click on it. Since I have a lot of classes, this can take a while. Here's how a bookmark can help. First, let's go back to the Bookmark Manager. In the Bookmark Manager, click on the 3 dots on the blue bar and click Add New Folder. Name the folder Classes and click Save. Now the folder is going to show up on the left side. Drag the folder to the top and put it where you want it so it shows up on your bookmark bar. Now go to your Google Classroom and click on your class. Click the star icon. And you can shorten the name of the class if you wish. Then click the drop-down folder and choose a classes folder that we just made and click done. Now I did this with all of my classes. Now you can have a folder on your bookmarks bar that holds your classes in it. All you need to do is click on the classes folder that you made in your bookmark bar and then click the class that you want and boom, you are there in a second. No scrolling or waiting for the main page of Google Classroom to load. You have saved so much time. And there is so much you can do with bookmarks. You can make a folder for each class and put specific resources that you use in them. You can even make a folder in a folder. The possibilities are endless. You can even bookmark a Google Doc, slide, sheet, or forms. You could save it all in a bookmark folder. You know how we get emails from staff with an important document? We'll quickly put that document into a bookmark folder by simply clicking on the star icon. Now you don't need to remember who sent it and dig through your emails trying to find it again. Oh, I also use bookmarks for Google Meet. Google Classroom automatically makes a different Google Meet link for each one of your classes and puts it on your Google Classroom site if you want to use it, which is really cool. But I share the same Google Meet link with all of my classes. That means I never have to log out between classes and it allows students to feel more connected, knowing that they can contact me at any time. I know what you're thinking, but I've never had a problem with this. So I bookmarked the exact Google Meet while I was already logged in with the code So when I click on my Google Meet bookmark, I don't have to put in the code now. I just click join and I'm ready to go. Thank you so much for watching my videos. Oh, you can even bookmark specific YouTube videos or your favorite YouTube channels too. I hope to see you in my next video.